20 affiliated Floorbus clubs have fired the Ghana Floorball Association's executive team in an effort to solve the governance, accountability and management problems that have impeded the growth of the sport. The clubs had an unusual meeting at the Lugogo Tennis Courts where they elected an interim executive and were joined by Sarah Chilengat, the NCS administrative secretary. James Hasindihe was defeated by John Vianney Mokalazi, who received 12 votes to take the presidency, outvoting Hasindihe's 7 votes. After receiving 12 votes, Mercy Ari Atiba was chosen as the technical director, defeating Vinkins Ruchamuzi, who received only 7. Rukundo lost to Ibrahim Kidu, who received 12 votes, for the position of development director. Other members, such as Vice President Joy Namagembe, Publicity Director Betty Mayanja, Treasurer Nabadadayana, General Secretary Semakula Francis, and Organizing Secretary Semboga Francis, were opposed. Peter Ogwang, the Minister of State for Sport, has issued a warning to federations that have failed to host events despite receiving funding from the government.
Cross-check if they receive money from government, because government money is according to the plans. So if there are no plans, no activity, then what is the money for? That I'll follow.
The newly appointed interim disclosed that they are striving to organize the office.
The plans for sport is right now, because our game is technical, so we need first to collect whatever equipment we've been having. We see how much of it can benefit the membership we have, and then how much is it that we are lacking. After that, we need to feed in all the clubs to be training, and then we put forward the calendar of our activities. The new enactment that is governing sports mandates us to cover at least 70% of the country, and that's where we are going to, the direction we are taking. We want to see that we grow the numbers for this sport, because even the sponsors look at numbers.
The prior regime's four-year term was meant to end in 2025, thus the interim executive will continue in office until